In this video series, I'm going to show you how to use our MP3 Audio Player Pro plugin for WordPress to create a beat store using Elementor and WooCommerce for WordPress. Hi, I'm Max from Sonar. If you're struggling with how to sell audio files with WordPress, this video walks you through exactly what you need to do so you can build your own professional beat store. You can check the video description to jump to chapters. Let's get started. The first thing you need to do when creating an audio store with WordPress is to make sure you have these plugins installed and activated. For this video tutorial, I have used the free version of Elementor Page Builder, WooCommerce to manage my digital audio product, which is also a free plugin, Advanced Custom Fields, which is also a free plugin and allows me to create custom fields for my products, or I can filter them later in the audio player, and MP3 Audio Player Pro that binds everything together to create the audio player, the audio filter, and the search widget. Now, if you want to get this specific template demo to get started, you can buy the Rebirth Elementor template from Sonar. The link is in the video description. Let's jump into the Elementor page builder so I can show you the widget we have used. The front-end interface is composed with four different widgets, included with the MP3 Audio Player Pro. The Audio Player, the Filter drop-down widget, the search widget, and the active filter chips widget. First of all, I have an audio player with the tracklist enabled. That is the masterpiece. The audio player's tracks are WooCommerce product that I have created earlier. I will show you how to create them later in this video. You can customize the player with many styling options, including a layout grid. Now, I have also the Sonar filter widget that contains four different dropdowns. The data sources of the dropdowns come from Advanced Custom Fill, which I'm going to show you in a moment. Now, to make the filter works and act as a track filter, you need to assign filters value to each of your products. Let me show you how it's done by editing a product post, and we will get back to the Elementor editor later. So I'm going to the products menu, then choose a product. So this is a variable product. This is the product variation and prices if you sell different audio licenses for the same product. See the video description for a complete video tutorial on how to set up product variations. This is the file that your customer will download once they have purchased the product. It's probably gonna be a WAV file or high quality MP3 or a STEM file. Now, this is the Sonar custom fields where you set the audio source. This is the file that's gonna play in the audio player. You should use MP3 file here. Now, if you don't see those audio player fields, make sure you have enabled the product post type in the MP3 audio player settings. Right here. Now let's go back to the product. This is the custom fields created from ACF. They allow us to filter the products on the front end. I'm gonna show you how to add the new custom fields here. Now let's say you want to add a new filter called the music category with three different options. So you want to display the new filter here, and you want to add a new drop-down filter here. So I'm going to custom fields, I already have a custom group called Product ACF. I'm gonna click it. What you see here are those fields are the ones that already show up in the product edit screen and are also available as a filter option in Elementor Editor. So I'm gonna add a new field. For the field type, I'm gonna choose checkbox. Category. And for the choices, I will add jazz, hip hop, and rock. Save change. Now let's go back to the product edit screen. I will choose my product called Drum Upbeat. And if I scroll down, I see my new music category custom field here. I will choose a jazz because this product is a jazz product. Click Update. Now let's add this new custom field as a filter dropdown into Elementor Editor. Let's jump back in Elementor Page Builder. I will just hit the refresh so my new changes show up. I'm gonna edit the filter widget, add item, and if I look for the source ACF, I will see my new custom field here. Choose music category. I will label it category. I will publish my page or update it, and on the front end I will refresh, and as you can see here I have a new category with jazz, hip hop, and rock. I choose jazz and I have my drum upbeat product showing up here. Now let's say I want to add a search bar right up there. I'm going to the Elementor Editor, search for search bar, search tracklist, sorry. I drag it here. The placeholder can be anything. Search for beats. And the target player ID is very important. So this is my audio player. I go to Advanced. And I have already an ID, which is player 93. I'm going to copy the ID and paste it here, target player ID. So I have a search. Click update. Now this is my old value, and I have a search here. So I search for night. And I have my night product. To add an active filter chips widget, which is very useful to see the active filters enabled. So those are the chip filters. So if you want to use them, you go to Elementor Editor, search for chips, and you set the player ID here, and that's it. If you have custom fields you want to display in the tracklist, you can do it very easily. I'm gonna edit the player with Elementor. Go to Style, go to Custom Fields Columns, and I'm gonna just delete the one already present. So I'm gonna add a new item, and here you choose the source of your custom field. In my case, I'm gonna choose ACF and Instruments. And here I have a column with my instrument custom fields.
name it the instrument for my heading. And you can choose the width the column will take. It's useful if you have multiple columns. And you can adjust the content where you want to display it. So I'm gonna add a new item. And in this case, I'm gonna choose product tags, maybe. All right, so here I see all my tags. And that's it. All right, so I have teach you how to use our MP3 Audio Player Pro to sell music through WooCommerce. Now, what if you have thousands of products to manage? This can be very, very time consuming. Fortunately, there are plugins allowing us to speed the process. First, we have an importer tool here. In the MP3 player, import MP3 file. I assume that your MP3 are already uploaded in your media library. So once they are uploaded, you can select them all here. Select post type, you choose product. You choose variable product if you manage multiple licenses per product. And create post. So when you go to product, you see all the product you have imported as a draft. You can select them all and go to edit and publish them. Update. Now all the products are published. I go on my front end, click refresh. And all the new products appear here. Now you have probably noticed that the player is now pink. It's just because we are developing a new feature called Enable Dynamic Colors AI. Will automatically set the color palette to match the image artwork. Let me quickly show you how it works. So I will just activate the mini player at the top of the tracklist here, and when I select a playlist, another product, it will automatically match the image artwork color scheme. So let's go back at tips and tricks about managing multiple products. We highly recommend using the Admin Column Pro plugin, which is this plugin. It allows you to organize, find, and update WordPress content in seconds within the admin column. I will show you an example. So I have Admin Columns Pro activated, and what it does, it creates columns here, and you can inline edit each values very quickly. And the third party plugin I want to show you today is the Product Bulk Editor for WooCommerce by WP Swings. It allows you to add product variation and license attributions to all of your audio files in one click. It's very useful if you manage multiple products. If you want me to do a video tutorial on this plugin, let me know in the comment. Check the video description for links to the plugin I have mentioned in this video. That's it for today. I hope you liked the video. If you have questions, let me know and I'm going to help you out. Have a great one.